Namaskar students, this video is for class 8 maths and we are continuing with the chapter data handling. And today we are going to learn about histograms. In the previous video, we have learned about group data. We have seen how we can form a group frequency distribution table. And if we do the graphical representation of that group data, then it is called histogram, or we can say the bar graph of group data is called histogram. Now, what is the difference between bar graph and histogram? In bar graph, there are gaps between the bars, whereas in histogram, there is no gap between the bars. Now, let us see few examples of histogram. Now, in example 1, we are having a table. It says a class interval is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40 and 40 to 50, and the frequency of each class has been given. Now we have to do the graphical representation of this group data, that is we have to draw a histogram. And to draw a histogram, first we will draw one horizontal line and one vertical line. The horizontal line is the x-axis and the vertical line is the y-axis. On x-axis, we represent class interval and on y-axis, we represent frequency. Now, the class interval is of 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30. That is, the class size is 10. So, at a distance of 1 square unit, we will write 10. That is, on x-axis we will take 1 square unit is equal to 10. So on x-axis you mark it as 0, 10, 20, 30 and so on. Now on y-axis we have to represent frequency, and you see most of the frequency which is given over here are the multiple of 4.
Two.
So on y-axis we will take 1 square unit is equal to 2. So on y-axis we will mark like 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, like this. Now in the interval 0 to 10 we have the frequency 4. Now so you will do in 0 to 10 you have to draw one rectangular bar till 4. Similarly, for the class interval 10 to 20, we have the frequency 10. So here, from 10 to 20, we will draw one rectangular bar with height 10. That is, here on y-axis, here you can see is 10. So we have to draw a bar with the height of 10. Similarly, you will do the other bars for the other class intervals. Now, as you see here, the class interval is starting from 0. You see the first bar will be touching the y-axis. Now, let us see one more example where the class interval is not starting from 0. In example number 2, we have a group data which shows the class interval from 30 to 35, 35 to 40, 40 to 45, 45 to 50 and 50 to 55. And the frequency of each class interval has been given. And we have to draw a histogram for this class interval. So similarly, you will draw the x-axis and y-axis. On x-axis, you will represent class interval and on y-axis, you will represent frequency. Now you see the class size of this given class interval is 5. So on x-axis we have taken the scale of 1 square unit is equal to 5. So on x-axis you will mark it as 30, 35, 40, 45, 50 and 55. And you see the frequencies are mostly multiple of 5. So on y-axis we have to take the scale of 5. That is, 1 square unit is equal to 5. So you will mark it as 5, 10, 15, 20 and so on. Now you see here between 0 and 30 I have drawn one zigzag line. This zigzag line shows that there is no data to be represented between 0 to 30. Now you have to draw bars. Like in class interval 30 to 35 we are having 15. So from 30 to 35 in between this we have to draw a rectangular bar with the height 15. Similarly in the class interval 35 to 40 we have the frequency 30. So here you will draw the bar with height 30. Similarly we will draw the rectangular bar for each class interval. Now here you see there is no gap between the bars, as there is no gap between the class intervals. Now let us see the exercise 5.1. Exercise 5.1, question number 1 says, for which of these would you use a histogram to show the data? Here there are 4 conditions given and you have to say out of these 4 conditions which conditions you can draw a histogram. Now you see in condition number B and D. In B we have the height of competitor in an athletic meet, and number D the number of passengers boarding train from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. at a station. See, for these 2 conditions, that is number B and number D, we can draw a histogram, as we can get a varieties of entry on these 2 conditions. Now let us see the next question. That is question number 4. Question number 4 says, draw a histogram for the frequency table made for the data in question number 3 and answer the following question. Here there are 3 questions. Now first you see it says we have to draw a frequency table for the data in question number 3. Now question number 3 we have already solved. In question number 3 we have got the frequency table like this. This is the class interval we have got, that is from 800 to 810, 810 to 820 and so on, and the frequencies for each interval we have got. Now based on this table you have to draw a histogram like we have discussed so far. Now the histogram for question number 4 will look like this. On x-axis you will represent the class interval, that is like 800, 810, 820, 830, 840 and so on, and y-axis you will represent the frequency and you will mark it as like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 till number 10. Then you will draw the bars. Now students, when you are drawing this histogram, 2 things you will keep in mind. That is, you have to mention the scale in your graph, as well as you have to label your axis. That is, x-axis is showing class interval and y-axis is showing frequency. Now students, I'm stopping here, and in this exercise we are having question number 5 also. This question you will going to do it by yourself. So till then, thank you. Namah Shivaya.